Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Microsoft Flight Simulator. I'm Martin Wenzel. This is Flight 66 of our world tour. And we're starting out today, this morning, about 6:45 a.m. at Osvaldo Vieira International Airport in Bissalanca, Bissau, Guinea Bissau. And we're going to be headed to Blaise Diagne International Airport in Dakar, Senegal. We're not going to be taking off a new country today. We've already been to Senegal, but we're going to be setting up for our next flight, where we will be completing another country on our world tour. This flight is based on ASCII Airlines Flight 53, flown using a Boeing 737-800, but I will be using the Airbus A320 with the FlyByWire A32NX mod, with the ASCII Airlines livery created by Marshall West, Alpha India Group's traffic, and Bijan Habashi's four season pack. Not seeing a lot of traffic right now, but in any case, let's get in the plane and get it ready. There we go. Get our flashlight. Make sure our parking brake is set. Flaps and speed brake is retracted. Engine masters are off. Ignition is set to normal. Idle, or our throttle is set to idle. Landing gear down. Want our nose wheel steering and anti-skid. Right there. Actually, probably want that off until we actually get done with our pushback. Wipers are off, and we can on our battery 1 and 2. We do have external power. Turn that on as well. And for some reason, the lighting isn't working. Going on with that. We're having some lighting issues. Be a big deal since we'll be getting some sunlight soon. Alright, got external power, strobe lights set to auto, our navigation, nav 1, 2, and 3, get those lining up, APU and fire engine tests, engine fire tests. Get our fuel coming on. Not waiting too long on that, and we'll start getting our passenger very soon. Fuel we need 5,694. Five minutes, real time refuel. And let's get our passengers coming on board as well. Emergency lights are on. Armed. No smoking and seatbelt sign. Once we actually have the fuel all on board. Pop open pack X today. Start flight. 171 passengers, so it's going to take a little while to get on board.
recording music. Let's ambient, and we'll do in-flight entertainment system. And let's get our flight computer set up as we...
Yeah, how much longer do we have on our boarding process?
I see PACX takes a while to board. Okay, 37 minutes is our estimated flight time. Here and our flight number is going to be 53. Alternate airport day is Gulf Quebec, November Oscar. Cost index 10. Cruising is flight level 240, so 24,000 feet today. That's a short flight. Our flight plan. Our first waypoint is Comore. And we're going to have an airway Bravo 600. Flight computer takes a seems to take a little while. There we go. We're gonna take that to the Banjul VOR, Bravo Juliet. Insert, and then that's about it. Then we have our standard terminal arrival route. ILS X-ray. And Banjul, or Bravo Juliet 1 Delta. Check this out. We're just going to go no vias, just go straight to final. That. Archer. We runway 21. Check out the plan. Roll through the waypoints. Got something going weird going on here. Digby and I370. Gonna go. Clear one of these. Uh, Why can't I remember how to do this now? Should just be able to click. That's weird. How do I clear that discontinuity? I used to be able to do this, now I can't remember how. Always something comes up weird like that. Quite a few flight plan discontinuity really going on. I'm in plan mode. Oh. That's kind of frustrating. I guess it's only on the CRJ that you can move it, but there should be a way for me to move the... Really weird. I forgot completely how to do that. Just got to do a direct to get to that point. Really weird. Alright, well, I'll have to remember that. Performance, I've already thrown everything into the calculator, it's just a spreadsheet. So our takeoff V1 141, 142 for our V rotate, and our V2 speed 144. Transition altitude gonna be 3,000 feet. That's where we switch from our ground pressure to our standard pressure. Laps 1, and our flex takeoff temperature is 59 degrees. Actually, I did all my calculations with flaps 2. Oh, flaps 2. We've got all our fuel on board, so we can turn on those seatbelt signs. Go to our performance page. Oh, that's our performance initial page too. Zero fuel weight, center of gravity. and our fuel planning. 5.7 on board. Turn our predicted wind shear on and lock the cockpit door. See if we can get our clearance and everything.
Bissau Tower, Sky Airline 53 IFR to Golf Oscar Bravo Delta, ready to copy.
Sky Airline 53 is cleared to Golf Oscar Bravo Delta Airport as filed. Takeoff runway 21 climb and maintain 6,000 feet. Departure frequency is 129.5, clock 3556.
Sky Airline 53 cleared to Golf Oscar Bravo Delta Airport as filed. Takeoff runway 21 climb and maintain 6,000 feet. Departure on 129.5, squawk 3556.
Sky Airline 53, read that correct. Contact ground on 124.3. Good day.
All right, our VOR ADF, if required, FCU altitude, our initial speed as required, heading dashed, and alignment check. IRS alignment check, EFIS is ARC in 10 nautical miles, and flight directors are both on. And let's get our APU going. Actually, before we do our APU, we actually need to have our fuel pumps on. Check our crew oxygen supply. All other lights are cleared. Yeah, for some reason the overhead integral lighting isn't working. Actually, it's not working on most things, really. APU is coming up. Our navigation lights. Once we got the APU, we will disconnect the external power.
On behalf of the cabin crew, I'd like to welcome you aboard our flight. As you find your seat, be sure to place your larger carry-on items in the overhead bins and smaller items underneath the seat in front of you. If you have trouble finding a location for any of your carry-on items, please use the flight attendant call button over your seat and somebody will assist you. If the overhead bin is full, please make sure you close it as a courtesy to other passengers. Please double-check that all your items are put away so that the aisle is clear and other passengers can make their way to their seats. If you're in an emergency exit row, please leave the exit seating responsibilities in the card and the seatback in front of you. If you're not able to comply with these actions, please let a flight attendant know so that way you can be released. Now's the time to get out any last-minute text messages if you need to, but we ask that once you depart from this, put away any laptops or tablets. Thank you, and welcome aboard.
Thank you. All right. Double checking everything. The sun is coming up. And we are just about boarded. And while we're sitting here, I'm going to get in the ILS for our arrival.
We're ready to go when you are.
And the VOR.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard flight 53. Our flight time will be roughly 37 minutes. Now that the cabin door is
turn
closed,
our beacon light on.
All devices are in airplane mode, and your large device
and
is
we don't really need a pushback.
Please fasten your seatbelt and make sure that all tray tables and seatbacks are in a full upright and locked position for departure.
Flight right out there. I get this power truck out of here. Your nose wheel steering on. And starting engine 2.
Light is not on, we suggest that you keep your seatbelt fastened in case of unexpected turbulence. Please take a few moments to now locate one of the several emergency exits on this aircraft. In some cases, your nearest exit may be behind you. In case of an emergency and we need to evacuate the aircraft, there is lighting on the floor that will guide you towards the exit. In the event of a decompression, an oxygen mask will drop in front of you. To start the flow of oxygen, pull the mask towards you. Place it firmly over your nose and mouth, secure the elastic band behind your head, tighten the straps if necessary, and breathe normally. Although the bag does not inflate, oxygen is flowing to the mask. If you are traveling with a child or someone who requires assistance, secure your mask on first and then assist others. Keep your mask on until a member of the crew advises you it is safe to remove it. In the unlikely event of a water landing, a life vest is located in a pouch under your seat or between the armrests. When instructed to do so, open the plastic pouch and remove the vest. Flip it over your head. Wrap the straps around your waist and buckle at the front. Hold the straps tight. Place the vest, pull firmly on the red cord only when exiting the aircraft. If it doesn't inflate automatically, you may blow into the mouth to use for a manual inflation.
It's starting engine 1.
Please make sure to exit the aircraft as soon as possible and leave your belongings. Once again, all devices must be in airplane mode.
You can see I shifted our, what is that, the trim, the 0.7 up. For our calculator again.
We remind you that this is a non-smoking flight. Tampering with, disabling, or destroying the smoke detectors located in the laboratory is prohibited by law. All of this information and more can be found in the safety card located in the seat back in front of you. We suggest using this and let us know if you have any questions. Thank you for flying with us and we hope you enjoy your flight.
All right, we are ready. Taxi, let's get our exit clearance.
Bissau ground, Sky Airline 53, ready to taxi IFR.
Sky Airline 53, taxi to and hold short of runway 21 via taxiway cross runway 21. Contact tower on 124.3 when ready.
Bissau ground, Sky Airline 53, ready to taxi IFR.
Sky Airline 53, taxi to and hold short of runway 21 via taxiway cross runway 21. Contact tower on 124.3 when ready.
Taxiing hold short runway 21 using taxiway cross runway 21, Sky Airline 53.
Alright, just getting everything set right before we go here. Get our weather radar on. Parking brake is already off. Start the chronometer. Double check map to see which way we're going. We're going to come out, we're going to turn to our right. Reason the power check doesn't want to move.
Flight attendants, please prepare for takeoff.
Nice of the ground vehicles would wait for me. We're gonna have to double back on the runway.
Chow Tower, ask Airline 53 ready for departure runway 21 IFR to Golf Oscar Bravo Delta.
Ask Airline 53 QNH 29.85 wind 234 at 5. Cleared for takeoff runway 21.
Cleared for takeoff runway 21, ask Airline 53.
We're clear for takeoff. Should be. Yep. Go to standard pressure, and to gear up, and landing lights at 10,000 feet. I think there are way more trees, and that's a result of the Four Seasons mod. He adds in a lot of beautiful 3D trees. Not a ton of fall ones in this area, because we are south of the equator, I think.
Level 240, ask Airline 53. Level 5 for ASK Airline 53. Dakar Center ASK Airline 53 is passing flight level 235 descending 6,000 feet.
ASK Airline 53 Dakar Center, continue as planned.
heading right over Banjul Airport, the VOR Bravo Juliet, and city of Serekunda, and right on that peninsula, right off our wing, is the capital city of Gambia, Banjul. Direct 2 here. And begin our descent. Starting our standard terminal arrival path, or route. We're actually pretty close, I didn't realize. Put our destination data in. Performance. UNH at our destination is 1013. Outside air temperature is 24 degrees Celsius. Wind 360 at 17 knots, so we got a little bit of wind there. It's going to be a tailwind, I want to say. Yeah, because we're going to be coming in about... not what I want to do there. We are going to be coming in at 7 degrees, so we'll be a little, basically wind right behind us. Transition altitude. Going to be 3,500 feet. Once we get to our waypoint DPAL, 3,000 feet, and then we're going to take, looks like about eight nautical miles when we capture our ILS. And as we're descending, let's take a look at our passengers. Again, we got the localized names from PAC-X. A lot more Western Africa type names. All right, easing up on our descent. Get our speed down to 250 knots as we're going to cross 10,000. And we'll flip on our landing lights once we cross 10,000 feet. Start working on getting slowed down. Basically making a little bit of a course adjustment. You get lined up with the runway, which is probably right over there. Field's not in sight yet, but I'm assuming they're giving us runway 1 because they haven't given us anything else yet.
Turn left heading 335 for Zumo navigation, ask airline 53.
You can see we got discontinuity there, so we'll have to quickly get a Bravo Delta 501 input. That's where we'll capture the glide slope. India Delta Sierra is our glide slope, our ILS. So we are headed over Dakar. Sorry, Dakar is going to be further over there. We're headed over Opengouin, Negoko, India. You can see the runway right in front of us. Got to put our minimums in. 580.
Please prepare for landing.
Just waiting on you folks. We're ready up here.
No problem.
then the ILS take us in, and we'll take over about the minimums. Landing speed is 116 knots.
2,500.
They cleared me to Delta Sierra and then come back out. That's why. Let's get this in here.
Ask Airline 53 would like ILS X-ray runway 01 approach vectors to final.
Ask Airline 53, you are 7 miles south. Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect vectors ILS X-ray runway.
They didn't clear us to land, but they should have just had us direct in.
Maintain present heading and altitude. Expect vectors ILS X-ray runway 01 approach. Ask Airline 53.
I'm gonna see if these trees. Yeah, we do have some autumn trees up here. Camera gets a little funky there. Sorry about that. It looks like we're getting a little wind pushing us around. Disengage the autopilot and the auto thrust, bringing it in ourselves. A little high now.
Hundred above. 300. Minimum. 200. Fifty. 40. 30. 20. Retard. 10. 5.
Okay, landing. Kind of drifted a little to the right of center there, but...
If this is your final destination, please
Stay toward the center of the runway. Let's get our parking assignment. Probably gonna be straight in front of us.
Ground ask airline 53 request taxi to parking.
Ask airline 53 taxi to general aviation parking using taxiway Charlie 4 Alpha 3.
Taxiing to general aviation parking using taxiway Charlie 4 Alpha 3. Ask airline 53.
This is going to be right in front of us. We're currently on Charlie 4, and once we cross Alpha, or this is Charlie right here. No, this is Alpha. No, Charlie, and then this will be Alpha in front of us. That sign is. And once we cross this, now we're in Alpha 3. And we'll just go for this gate right in front of us.
Airline 53, hold position caution, other traffic.
Hold position, ask airline 53.
Ask airline 53, continue taxi.
Roger, ask airline 53.
Alright, parking brakes set. Lights off. APU on. And cut back the engines. Belt signs off. Beacon light off. Fuel pumps off. Barrel power on. APU bleed. Master switch off. Your oxygen supply off, and our deers off.
All right, while we're waiting for our passengers to board, check out our flight, complete it now, and it's not telling us we're the only ones to be here today, but review our flight. Good looking flight, not too many issues route-wise. Landed great, a little hard, 273 feet per minute. G-force though, 1.06, just fine. Fuel just under 2,000 kilos, 203 nautical miles, 38 minutes for our flight time, 1 minute longer than planned. Landing speed, we were a little slow, about 10 miles or 10 knots slower than we need to be. And just an overview of our world tour so far. We completed much of Africa, and here we are back in Senegal right here. All right, our next flight's going to be to Mali. All right, we can see our flight report from Pack X. Like I said, I love the flight reports we get from self-loaded cargo, but Pack X is really cool with our localized names, and it just works very well with Microsoft Flight Simulator right now. So comments, I'm absolutely parched. Well, don't know why no one gave you any drinks. I'll definitely be recommending you at work. That was a quick flight. I'm glad World Tour continued. Press. All right, so our next flight will be to Mali. It's gonna be on Air Senegal in the A320. If you haven't already, please like the video, leave a comment below, share it with your friends, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. And until that next flight, keep the blue side up, happy flying, and take care.